And before we go, what am I doing? We're not even nearly ready to go. We need to check the mail really quickly, and my control is not set to Zoom. Where is it? Somewhere. There we go. Much better. We need to go check the mail before we go, and we also need to do something with the plants. So if you watched the last episode, and you would only have had to have watched the first 20 seconds, because it's literally what I'm about to talk about, I said that I unfortunately lost a recording, or one of the clips, where we did stuff with the plants, but I did manage to keep one where we got the Welwitzia, which is what we have here. So what we're going to do is we're going to head over to, before we take the ducks, because I've just remembered, so let's put the ducks away really quickly. We're going to head over to Froggy at the QA Centre. We're going to leave her these Welwitzia pieces, and hopefully she can propagate those for us. And we're going to head back to South Africa really quickly, and we're not going to go back to the mine. We're just going to go and gather up some plant samples, because that is what I intended to do originally, but that clip has been deleted, so it's all set up again for us, ready to go. And then we'll come back, and we will check the mail, and then we will head off to Seri's and drop the ducks off. So first of all, let's turn the weather off, because it's going to cause some lag issues. Right, let's go visit Froggy. Hello Froggy, how are you? I'm just going to put some of these Welwitzia pieces in here for you. I'm sure you can work your magic. So hopefully by next episode, these will be potted up, and they'll be on the propagation tables here. And, ooh, look, you can see something poking out the chest. That's hilarious. Wait. Oh, I thought you could see them inside then. Hello, Puggles. But yeah, really quickly, we're gonna head back to South Africa. I know we said we were done with that, but that was my fault for messing up the recording. We're gonna bring you a couple more specimens, and yeah, I'll see you really quickly. Bye. Oh, I like how her flower band is 3D. So let's head on up to the teleporter really quickly, and do what we were supposed to do last time. And fingers crossed we are recording. I'm pretty sure we are. Yeah, so we've got the ducks. I feel like maybe I should have put them away. But oh well, we haven't. South Africa underscore. Why is it an underscore? That doesn't make any sense to me. Right, are we here? Are we here? I think we're here. Okay. And there's the mine. I wonder if they've rescued Anders from the hole yet. Well... let's just not tell them we're here. But if I remember correctly from last time, what is that? Hello? What? Who the hell are you? That didn't happen. Bye-bye. oh, look, a guinea fowl. Yeah, if I remember correctly from last time, if we go past this well, oh, there you go, you can see them up on the hill over there. Yeah, if we go past this well, which goes all the way down to bedrock, if you were wondering. So let's not go down there, we will drown. These are where we can actually find some of the plant specimens that we want to take back. So, okay, so there's four different plant specimens here that we're going to collect. And two of them are custom ones that I've added to the server. So what one should we talk about first? Let's talk about the torch lily. So the torch lily is Nyphophia uvaria, or a more common variety of Nyphophia is Nyphophia regini, which is the red hot poker, which is quite a common plant. It's about this tall, and it's got the really long bright red flowers, kind of trumpet shaped, and it looks like a tiki torch kind of, and they're actually a native of South Africa, and also quite a bit of Africa. So we're going to collect a couple of these to take back with us. These are a different, slightly different variety. These are called torch lilies, but they do look very similar. So, oh look, that one propagated for us. Brilliant. Okay, so these guinea fowls are running around. We're going to get some of these spice bushes. So spice bush, which is Nandina domestica, is a native of Africa. And spice bushes and tea bushes and things like that are something that are grown commonly in parts of southern Africa, not just South Africa, but southern Africa as an area of the continent in general. So we're going to take some of these back. So these two can go into pots because they're just ordinary flowers. And then we've got two more special species. So first of all, let's talk about this one first. So this is a bird of paradise flower, or Strelitzia regina. And we do actually have a different variety on the server. I'm not going to be able to find it over here. It might be in the jungle, actually. But I thought I'd make one that was actually truer to real life, how big they are. And so the way they grow is they usually grow in one plane, so they're very thin if you look at them from one angle. And they've got fronds, kind of like a palm leaf, and then they have a really tall flower spike, and then they have this stunning flower on top that is supposed to look like a bird of paradise. What am I trying to say? It's supposed to look like a bird, okay? And even though birds of paradise are from Asia, and the Indonesian islands and the Philippines, places like that, the bird of paradise flower is from Africa. So we're going to collect some samples of this, and what we're going to do, we're not going to take the flower head, we're just going to take some cuttings from the leaf, because, where did that go? There it is. That's the respectable and the sensible thing to do, responsible thing to do. As a biologist, we're not damaging the environment, we're just taking some cuttings that aren't going to be damaging to the plants. Let's put those away. Actually, let's put them in here. Why do we have a chocobo feather? Let's not question it. Let's put that there, let's put these here, and then the final flower, or the final plant that I want to collect samples from, before we head back to Oikos, is these proteas over here. So proteas are a really interesting plant. They're very unique. They're unlike any other flowers on Earth, really. I mean, I guess they're kind of similar to bromeliads in the way they look, but they're not epiphytic. They don't grow on trees, so they're not really like bromeliads in that sense at all. But they're a tall flower, or a tall plant, a woody plant, so they overwinter, and they've got kind of dull-coloured, very pointy, almost sharp leaves. And they have these enormous flowers, and they're not always pink. They're a huge array of colours. You get yellow, purple, white, things like that. But they're enormous flowers, and they're multi-head flowers, so they're a collection of many small flowers together. But they have the appearance of one huge flower. And you see them in flower displays quite a lot, just because of how beautiful they are. And they are, again, a native of the Fynbos to South Africa. Fynbos is the habitat that we're in right now, if you remember correctly. And this is another one of the species that you would probably, you wouldn't be lucky to see, you know. It's quite a common plant, actually. So we're going to take a couple of these with us to propagate. And unfortunately, I have to break the top off of these. So hopefully Froggy can collect some seed from them. And we picked up another Niphophia somehow. Let's put this here. There we go. So, good. We've done what we should have done last time. We came back and we collected up the flowers and the plants, and hopefully we can get them propagated and ready for people to come and take home with them if they want, like we did with the, what was it called? The Lamatia tasmanica last time. So a couple of people, I think Gamer K, I think Aaron, and I think Seri, I'm not sure of anybody else, but those people actually came over and they took some of the King's Holly home with them, and then I planted up the rest for our Tasmanian floral display in the Outback Zone. So we're going to be doing a similar thing with the South African area, and that's something else I actually wanted to talk about. Do you guys think that I should do a South African area of Oikos? Or do you think I should do a horse area of Oikos? So if it was a horse area, we would have the quagga, the Birchall's zebra, and then the horse species that I am looking for next, the next adventure that we go on, hopefully in a couple of episodes' time. So that would be a horse area. Or do you want just South Africa? So we'd have the quagga and the zebra, but we'd also have the Damaraland mole rats in that bit with them. And we could probably get some other animals. We could get the guinea fowl walking around, ambient. We could get some gemsbok, some giraffes, rhino, I suppose. So that would be a South African zone. But if we did the horse zone, we'd have to put the Damaran and Marowak somewhere else, and they'd probably have to go with the animal that we are also going to be collecting when we visit Mongolia. But the way I was thinking of it was, when you go to a zoo, in real life that is, they're not always divided up into sections. Like, sometimes they'll have certain areas that are, like, dedicated to one place or one type of animal, but usually you'll get, like, a random eclectic mix of animals relatively close to each other in the zoo. So you might get a lion next to a moose or something like that. So what do you guys think? Do you want a South African zone, and then we'd have to do a Mongolian or a Central Asian zone alongside that? Or do you want a horse area? I want to call it Equus something, use the Latin name for a horse. Equus Centralis, something like that, horse centre. Yeah, so what do you think? Let me know in the comments. So let's go on over and head back to Oikos really quickly, and we're going to check the mail. Oh no, we're not. We're going to drop these plants off at Froggy's propagation area. Let's go down the ladder really quickly, and I did not give the chunks any time to load in, so we're going to be lag city right now, but let's really quickly run on over. I feel like it's going to rain again. It's getting dark and overcast. Watch out, Puggles, I need to get in the chest. Oh, I don't want to hit you with my sword. Oh, and I didn't even get them out of my bag. What am I doing with my life? Okay, right, let's get these guys out. Right, so we've got the Proteas here. And then we've got the Strelitzia regina here and here. And then we've got the Spice Bush and the Torch Lily. So I'm confident that you'll be able to work your magic, Froggy. So next episode, they'll all be potted up ready for us to talk about. I think the Welwitsia will write up a care guide like we did with the King's Holly, so that should be ready for next time. But yeah, let's head on over and check out the mail really quickly before we take the ducks to Seri, because I nearly forgot to do that. Oh, and I discovered, I forgot to say, that there's actually a DecoCraft altar, Muertos altar, or Altar de Muertos, or something like that, that perhaps I could put in the back or something like that. So I might do that for next time. And it's raining again. It's raining again, isn't it? I knew it. Okay, right. Never mind. Let's look in the mail. Oh my god, okay. Okay, what have we got? Ooh, a Dominican Amber. What the heck is that? That's really cool. It's like changing texture. That's awesome. Do we have a whale? We have a whale. We have a whale in the mail. We have a whale in the mail. A whale! Oh my god! £52,500. What do you do with a whale? I could turn you into whale steak. I don't know if I want to do that. And then I can cook the whale steak. And I can make a whale burger. And being from Iceland, I'm quite acquainted with... well, I'm not, because I've never eaten whale, but people do that. Eat whale relatively often, or they used to anyway. It's not really common practice anymore. I honestly have no idea where we're going to put this whale. You can't spawn it. Oh, thank you, sorry. We have a whale now. Literally no idea where to put this. Let's find this. There we go. We're going to keep a whale on the shelf, because that's a perfectly normal thing to do. Yes, I have no words. I have no words for that. That's so cool. We've got a whale in the mail. Okay, what else have we got? We've got some collection of harvest. Oh, and how did I do that? I just threw them on the floor. Okay. I have no idea why they keep throwing themselves on the floor. So we've got mangoes, eggplants, sweet potatoes, winter squash, lettuce, and honeycomb. Oh, and onions. Wow, that's quite a broad range of vegetables. That's really awesome. Oh, these are cool. Oh, we've got some parrot eggs and some kiwi eggs. Oh, we don't have the incubator set up. It's away in storage. I don't know where to put them. I'm going to put them away somewhere special that I haven't yet located. Let's put them up here. I want you and you. So I'm going to have to remember to set up a place to hatch them really soon. That's really cool. And actually, kiwis will fit in perfectly with one of the expeditions that I have in mind for the future. So we're talking, you know, maybe next month, certainly after Halloween, which we need to do the Halloween event. The Halloween event that Parvo set up. I actually helped him set it up, so I do actually know what it is, but we're still going to do it nonetheless, and it's still going to be really exciting. But yeah, after we do that, we'll probably start thinking about other expeditions, and the kiwis will fit in perfectly with that. And maybe the parrots too, because, okay, right, I'm thinking in my head, I'm like, I could retext to the parrots, and you guys don't know what I'm talking about, because I don't want to tell you, but so many exciting things. Okay, anyway, blaze powder. Okay, that's to, I know what that's to for. That's to help hatch the eggs, isn't it? So let's put that away in here. Oh, somebody's texting me. Right, some blackberry Danish. Oh, that sounds nice. Nibbles of nut muffin. Walnut pecan pie. Sunflower seed pretzel. Oh, apple cinnamon scones. They sound really nice. And then some tricycle officinale, a dandelion puff. A coffee ice cream. That sounds nice. Let's put stuff away. Never mind. We have absolutely no space to put anything away. I'm going to leave these things in here, just for the time being. I'll put them away off camera, but we've got quite a lot to do today, so I just need to get them out of the inventory right now. But we've got some coffee ice cream that gives you night vision. Okay, that's really cool, and I want to know what this does. This looks awesome. Ooh. Ooh, okay, I combine you with a scarab gem. How do I make a scarab gem? You don't. Okay, you just have to find it. And then the aquatic... What do you do? I have no idea what this does, but I'm sure it's... Oh, Luca's here. Hey, all. Oh, it's late for Luca, isn't it? It's like 1 in the morning or something like that. I'm not sure. But we have 2 pieces of mail, so I'm assuming we'll read this one first. Hey, old Jacob. Once again, I wander into your area and feel like a gawking tourist. Everything is just so beautifully built, and I love seeing what you do with all the different materials, not to mention the new animals and geography that you show off. Thank you so much for the heads up on the ducks, too. Poor puppy the mallard has been quite lonely. I really appreciate you letting me look around your place for some companions for him. Which reminds me, I wasn't too sure about what to bring your way, but I hope the bird eggs I picked out will be potentially exciting additions to your projects. Yes, they will. There is some blaze powder as well to help them hatch. Yes, okay. I didn't mean to say it like that. That sounded so rude. I'm like, yes, okay. No, I mean like, okay, yeah, put the blaze powder away already. Oh, and some snacks and various shops around Sudesia Zoo. I hope you're having a great day and settling into your studies for the school year. Love, Seri. It doesn't even say love, Seri. What am I talking about? From Seri. Oh, that's so nice. Okay, always such nice things when people come by. Let's put you away. There we go. And then I have a PS. It says, the food is from local eateries, and the dandelion puffs are from my lightning lucky hedgehog to make wishes on if you wish. Haha, wishes on if you wish. Okay, right, let's put that away there. And I guess we could take a dandelion puff. Oh, no, not that. Where are you? Let's just take one. And okay, thought we crashed then. And I think we could just, like, blow it into the wind, right? That's cool. Oh, did you make a wish, guys? Keep it secret if you did. I finally have like 30 minutes free time. Yay. I'm going to leave this rotated so I remember that there's things in here that I need to go through. And I need to put the food in my backpack, but I don't have space right now. But yes, we need to head over to Sarah's place and drop off these ducks. Where has my food gone? I don't have any food at all now. I can't eat. Can I eat the crackers? These are from Erin, right? I'm pretty sure these are from Erin, right? There we go. Let's eat these. Let's put them away. Oh, and I was coughing again. And in the time that I was coughing, the rain has decided to start again. How typical. Okay, so I went ahead and I just put down some basic fences. And this is just so that Seri knows the ducks are here, and so they don't wander off or drown while she's still working on the area. But let's just plop them down. There should be 3 females and a male. Perfect. 2 of these females actually hatched from eggs that these 2 laid. So I'm not sure which one's the mother. Doesn't really matter. But hopefully one of you can be a mate for Puppy the Duck, and then the rest of you can be his friends. And I'm pretty sure that Puppy and the other ducks can't escape from this area except for through... Oh, I've fallen. Except for through here. And I'm pretty sure Puppy has literally just wandered off while I was setting up this fence. So I'm going to go ahead and find him, because we don't want him to drown or anything. So, where have you gone, Puppy? Okay. Oh, okay. Thank God. Oh, lag. Okay. Who's that? Asterseed. I was really worried we wouldn't be able to find him, and he was just going to escape, and he'd be gone forever, which would be awful. There we go. Lag. I'm going to put Puppy in here. So if you guys could do me a favor, and when Seri uploads her episode, and she's like, why is Puppy the Duck moved? Just tell her that it was me. And these are the two eggs that I gathered from my area. So let's put them in these nests. And this guy, he keeps occasionally giving me things. But yeah, I think that's good. I think that's everybody. What's that? Oh, okay, that's just the mod that makes the logs round. I was really confused then. I've got some mud. What do I do with... Oh, you can throw it like a snowball. Okay, good to know. Yeah, Puppy. I hope you're happy with your new friends. One of you's Puppy. I'm not sure which one. Wait, are you Puppy? Wait, oh yeah, you're Puppy. Okay. Good. I was worried neither of them were Puppy. It was like, conspiracy theory. Yes, so... There you go, Seri. There's your duck arrivals. And I've actually got a book and quill here that I'm going to head over up to her house. And I'm just going to leave her something in the mail so that she knows the ducks have arrived. So, you just see a zoo entrance. And you guys are going to see this episode probably quite a bit after Sarah's episode. Unfortunately, because I need to put the episode before this up that I've recorded before you're seeing both of these, it's all really confusing. But yeah, trust me. But that doesn't matter. Let's go to Sarah's house. I think I just heard a skeleton. Ooh. Oh, don't crash. Fingers crossed. My stomach is growling. Looks like I need to eat something. Okay, good. Let's head on down to her... mailbox, and then we've got, I need to show you guys, I can, thank you, I've got a lupine, or a lupin, I suppose it's supposed to say. I have a new mod installed that changes the way that some of the vanilla mobs look, so the Enderman, and zombies, and spiders, and creepers as well. I think that's all of it. They should all look different, and as you can see, he's kind of crouched over. I can't show you all of him because I can't get in there to do that. But yeah, hopefully we see one in the wild one day and I can show you. What the heck is this? Block. Oh, it's a sticky piston. Okay, I was confused then. I need to write a note. Oh, and I didn't mention last episode, but the episode, two episodes ago from this one, when I tried out a different texture pack, I heard what you guys said. Everyone in the comments was like, we prefer the old one. The new one makes everything look a bit dead. I don't know if I agree if it made everything look dead, but if you guys don't like it, then I brought the old one back. So yeah, this is the original one. It's here to stay for good now. And yes, all the good things. So let's go ahead and sign this book. So, dear Seri, I have successfully delivered your new duck family, with a Y. They are settling in nicely with Puppy the Duck, which I'm spelling wrong, Puppy the Duck, down at the Swan Lake. Anything else I need to say? I have fenced them off along with Puppy to ensure that they don't escape whilst you're still securing the area. Is that good? Oh, we're going to have to go to the next page. Still securing the area. Okay. Successfully blah blah blah. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you enjoy them. Is that good? That'll do. Psst. New plants at Oikos soon. We'll let you know when they arrive. All the best. All the best. Jacob. Jacob isn't spelt with a B. A V even. It is spelt with a B. What am I saying? New ducks. Sign and close. Oh. What's happening? Okay. That was scary. And let's just leave that here. There's nothing else. Okay, good. Let's put that up. And just before we leave, I want to show you guys. I don't know if you've seen. You probably have seen. I don't know whether to plant this or not. I'm just going to put it there. No, I'm not. I'm going to put it there. Okay. I was actually the person that delivered the coconut crabs to Sarah's garden for her. And I just want to show you them. I think they're really cute. I worked out how you can use the NPC mod to make the crabs vertical like this. And they should actually, or maybe Seri disabled it, but they used to give you coconuts. But yeah, coconut crabs, just so you know, it was me. And you were, if you were wondering who it was that delivered the crabs, and I appear to be stuck. There we go. So let's hop on out. The frames aren't too great in this area, so let's head on back to Oikos really quickly. And then, what else do we need to do this episode? Let me think. There's one other thing. There's one thing left for this episode. It's probably a short episode. That's okay. I think what I'm going to do off camera is start work on the exhibition or the South Africa area. Just so that we can move the zebras and the quagga out of the QA centre. Because it's quite cramped in there. And we've run out of space for anything else. But one thing I want to show you is a couple of things. I've retextured the vines. So these are the flowering vines from the plant mega pack. You've probably seen them before. They were, in my opinion, they were really ugly. The way they looked, it was just this really fake looking, vibrantly green streaks with somewhat colour dotted in it to indicate what colour vine it was. I hated it. It was the one texture that I'd see all the time, and I hated it. I didn't think it fit in at all. So I retextured them, and these are all the colours. I'm not going to keep these because I didn't, I spawned them in, just so I could show you guys. So it's not fair to keep them, but I wonder why they haven't grown. Well, it's grown here. Okay, interesting. But yeah, what do you think? I think this looks 100 times better than the old texture. If I remember, I'll put up a picture of the old texture so that you can see a comparison. But yeah, so new texture. And then this is something that I actually made for Eros, and it would appear that my laptop has come unplugged. So let me plug that back in because it's saying that the battery's getting low, and I don't want it to die in the middle of a recording. Can you go in the hole, please? There we go. Yeah, this is a present that I made for Eros, and I just made it because I just thought, you know, nice people deserve nice things. And Eros is one of the nicest people I've ever met in my entire life. She just always asks how you are. She's always really supportive of everything that everybody does. When people are ill, she brings them gifts. And I just thought, what can we do to be nice and repay her? So I made this devincing rose bush, or rose tree, I suppose it more is, because it's very tall. And there is currently another one. It's over at Eros's house. So you can go watch her episode when she finds it. And it will actually give her roses. And I left a note to say it's from me. And Pavo, bye Pavo. But yeah, I just thought, you know, it's good to do nice things for your friends. So yeah, that's what this is. And with that, I believe that should be the end of the episode. It's been a shorter episode. Like I said, because we had a few things that we needed to do before we could do anything else, but those other things that we can do now, since we've done the things we did this episode, what am I saying? We can go ahead and do them now, but that'll be next episode. So yeah, shorter episode. Off camera, I'm going to be working in this area. This is actually the area where the zebras and all the other South African animals are going to go. Yeah, I'll work on that off camera a bit, not too much, because I know you guys like to see the building in the videos, so I'll save some of that for episodes in the future. But it's raining, as always, typical. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If you did, remember to leave a like, comment down anything you want me to do. If there's any textures that you've seen that I haven't put links out for, please say in the comments, because I keep forgetting to put the links down to them. And I really do like to give away my textures for you guys to use. And people do always ask, so I know I need to put the guinea fowl one in the description. If there's any others that you want that I've forgotten, please say and I'll put them in the description for everyone to use. But yeah, I have been the Irate Sloth, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye!